Grabbing headlines in the technology sector this year in Korea was HUBO, a humanoid robot that won the DARPA Robotics Challenge in the summer. Now, that victory has proven that Korea is rapidly emerging as a top robotics nation. Global media has since been focusing on Korea's technology in this sector, some saying it's reminiscent of how Korean carmakers rapidly caught up with their Japanese counterparts in recent decades as both nations sought to topple America's Big Three. So, how advanced is Korea's robotics technology? Our Kwon Jang-Ho went to meet HUBO and his team to find out himself.
Meet HUBO, weighing in at 80 kilos and standing at 1.75 meters tall. HUBO is a humanoid robot developed at the Korea Advanced Institute of Science and Technology to enter a robotics competition set up by DARPA, the U.S. Department of Defense research agency.
Thank you.
It was HUBO's versatility and quick feet, or wheels rather, that brought him the top spot at this year's DARPA's Robotics Challenge. The challenge was inspired in the aftermath of the nuclear disaster at Fukushima in 2011, and research was being done on how robots could be developed to help in similar situations. The robots did not look particularly pretty, but the challenge was about functionality, and HUBO passed with flying colors, completing all tasks in the quickest time. One of the most unique features is how it transforms down to use wheels in its knees, allowing it to move swiftly and stably. Falling over is still one of the biggest obstacles bipedal robots face. HUBO also has an ingenious way of traversing stairs and rough terrain by rotating its body and walking backwards. For Professor Oh, the mastermind of HUBO, it was a proud moment, but surely the journey was not easy. Different versions of HUBO have been in development since 2002.
We're very happy that HUBO came first, but that doesn't mean he's the best robot or we have the best robot technology in the world. But what we showed is that we can now compete with countries from whom we had learnt from in the past.
Korea has advanced greatly in the field of robotics, but Professor Oh warns that there's still a long way to go.
Korea is still a newcomer in the field of robotics, especially robotics for businesses. We basically import 100% of our manufacturing robots. The government and businesses need to think long-term, continue investing and encouraging research.
Further advancements and developments are continuously being done on HUBO, while at the same time HUBO has been busy, so as to speak, working as a model and tool for further research and education. Moreover, HUBO has even been invited to attend next month's World Economic Forum annual meeting in Davos.
The Davos Forum is where the world's top political, business and cultural minds gather. We'll show what HUBO can do, but we'll also look at what aspects they are interested in and see what we can take away from that.
Kwon Jang-Ho, Arirang News.